Hello everyone, greetings from Kharkov, Ukraine. My name is Svetlana Mukha and I'm the leading matchmaker and dating coach at Dula.com. Christmas is almost here and I hope that you can feel Christmas mood. I know that it has been a not easy year for many of us and definitely a very unusual year, but still Christmas holidays is always a good reason to gather with beloved people, gather together with family, and to relax, to think about important things, because of course business, jobs, careers, they help us to grow not only professionally but as personalities. They help us achieve new results and they help us become better people, but still family is always more important and it is vitally important to return back home, to know that there is a place where you can be loved, cherished and appreciated for the person you are. So I hope that you all will celebrate this Christmas and New Year holidays with dear people, surrounded by love, by care, by affection, and let's hope that 2021 will be more fun and all the borders will be open and we all will be able to travel around the globe to romantic destinations together with a special beloved person by our side. Right now, let's return to our video, what I was going to talk to you about today. I wanted to talk to you about stereotypes about Ukrainian ladies. I believe it is important to discuss it because so many people, so many foreign bloggers who have been to Ukraine and are blogging about dating Ukrainian women or life in Ukraine, so many people who have used paper letter dating sites, they assume that the image of the real Slavic woman is the image that is sent to the world, that is translated by these paper letter dating sites. And guys, you are so wrong about it. From time to time, I would say pretty often, unfortunately, below our videos, we receive comments from gentlemen who say something like, "Oh, why should I pay for the dinner with the Ukrainian lady? Or why should I bother courting her? Why should I bother buying her flowers? What will I give in return? It's like she's doing nothing and I have to pay for the dinner and I have to bring flowers. No, I'm not going to do that. It's like stupid." So I was trying to understand where these guys are coming from. Of course, these comments, they are angry and I can understand why these people are single and why it is complicated for them to build a relationship, because nobody wants to date an angry person. We all want to date someone who is sweet, who is kind, who feels okay in his own skin, who feels comfortable being single and who feels comfortable being in relationship, who is ready for a relationship. But in many cases, these gentlemen, they build their opinion about Ukrainian ladies based on paper letter dating sites that they have used. To be honest, despite the fact that I have been doing a professional matchmaking for 12 years already and I run a boutique matchmaking service and we are well acknowledged by the industry in the West, I often go to conferences by Matchmaking Institute or other international conferences. I often speak there, so they invite me as a speaker. But still, even among my colleagues, from time to time, I hear this stereotype that, "Oh, you are doing mail order brides." And I always tell that, no, I don't do mail order brides. For example, not so long ago, in one closed professional chat, one matchmaker from the US has written that a gentleman has reached out to her and he's 72 and he wants to date someone below 42 and he is from the US and he wanted to date a local American woman, and other matchmakers writing something like, "Good luck, that's not possible, we wish you luck, don't take him, it's ridiculous." And one matchmaker has written that, "Oh, you should probably ask Svetlana Mukha, she does mail order brides, maybe she can help." And usually when I see messages like that, I feel like rolling my eyes, but simply I have written that no, I don't do mail order brides. And there is this stereotype that if a gentleman is 72 and he has money, then for sure he can travel to Ukraine or Russia or to Belarus and he can find someone there, because all Ukrainian women are hot, beautiful and desperate. Guys, it's not so. Ukraine is not the country of hot, desperate women who are ready to marry whoever is willing to take them. It's not so. I already did several videos in which I have given you statistics that actually the percentage of women who have ever heard about marriage agencies or international people at a dating sites or have been registered there is like tiny. It's very small. So when some bloggers assume that all Ukrainian women have used this site or they have been there, it's not so. The majority, like the vast majority of Ukrainian women, have never even heard about people at a dating sites or some marriage agencies. And even if they heard about some marriage dating agencies, usually these agencies are surrounded with this stereotype that it is something dirty and they don't want to go there. So trust me, recruiting ladies into our base, you have to overcome this stigma and really build a reputation to prove decent women, decent ladies, serious ladies, that you can actually trust a reputable dating agency with your search. Of course, it is not for everyone, and not everyone will be open to international dating, and that's normal. Of course, in every culture and country, there can be websites promoting sugar babes, sugar daddies, and stuff like that. You can find it in the US, you can find it in UK, you can find it in Australia, you can find it in Ukraine as well. I don't know why PayPal letter international dating sites are just way more popular than such websites. Maybe they have better marketers, I don't know, or maybe the whole concept is a little bit more popularized than a local sugar babes website. But this doesn't mean that all Ukrainian women are desperate and are ready to sell their body and soul or to be married and to leave Ukraine. It's ridiculous. It's so far from reality. You can tell me right now that a relationship when the girl is broken, desperate and beautiful and the man is old and dirty rich exists. Well, I'm thinking right now about Anna Nicole Smith and her husband, the millionaire, billionaire, and I think they both have passed away, and she was a stripper and she was also into drugs, and he has helped her overcome this addiction. He has helped her build the career. She became a model. And I don't remember what was their age gap. Maybe it was 40, 50 years. But guys, we all know that such situations, such stories are very not common. And this is the reason they make headlines. And this is the reason they are all over the internet, because it is something unique. It doesn't happen all the time. And Ukraine is not the country of desperate, hot supermodels who are ready to marry guys in their 60s, 70s, 50s or 40s. And the whole idea that international dating equals a huge age gap is ridiculous. This idea leads to many disappointed, bruised male egos. So I can try to understand the logic of some gentlemen who below our videos write that don't give gifts to women in Ukraine, don't buy them flowers, they are evil and stuff like that. Because in my reality, I'm working with ladies and gentlemen who are serious about dating, who are serious about building a relationship. And Ukrainian women, they are proud to be women. They are proud to dress as women. They are proud to be feminine. And of course, in Ukraine, when the gentleman is courting a lady and the lady lets him court her, yes, guys, the lady, if she likes the man, she will let him court her. If she doesn't like the man, then she will show him or she will tell him that his courtship is not welcomed. So when a Ukrainian man is courting a Ukrainian lady, he takes her out to dinners, to lunches, to movie dates, to theaters, and yes, he is footing the bills, he is buying tickets, he is bringing flowers, he is telling her compliments, he is listening to her, he tries to make her smile and feel special. He is doing all this because he hopes to win her over. He hopes to win her over, to win her heart. And you can tell me right now that, oh wow, why does he have to invest so much to buy flowers, to spend time and money? What he will gain in return? In return, if he actually manages to win the heart of a beautiful Ukrainian lady, he will get a loyal, beautiful loving partner by his side. And it costs so much more than flowers and a few dinners. And also, if you will try to think a little bit deeper about gifts and about the process of courting, when the man is asking a lady out on dinner, is he doing it only for her or is he doing it also for himself? For sure, he's doing it only partly for her. For sure, he also wants to prove to himself and to her that he can afford it. He can afford it to take her to a nice place. And he is showing her that, look at me, I'm successful adult and I can take my woman out, I can order good wine, I can order nice meal, and I can do it. So if you will be with me, if you choose me, then we will have a good life. And it is a normal position. And it is a quite normal, a decent attitude. If you will think about engagement ring, do you think it is the gift for a woman or do you think it is something a man does to show the world that this woman is actually taken, that this is his woman, that he has won her over? Of course, engagement ring is a symbol of love, and still it is the symbol that shows other men around the woman that, hey, this girl is already taken. She has chosen her man, he has won her over, and they are together right now. Of course, it is nice when the lady actually likes her engagement ring, when it doesn't have skulls or many rings or, I don't know, any other atrocity. So it is nice when the gentleman is choosing something, thinking about her taste. But still, it's all about the man. When we are choosing presents for our family, for our friends, for our colleagues maybe, or for a really special beloved partner, we try to think what this person will actually like. We enjoy this process. We think, oh, should I buy him this or that? And we try to imagine how this person will react to our present. So we can claim that the person who actually is buying the gift, he is also enjoying this process. Of course, we all hope to receive a special emotion, special reaction from a person who will receive this gift. We hope that he or she will smile, he or his eyes will light up, that this person will try this gift on, if it is a sweater or whatever. We hope that this person will actually use this gift and will think about us and will make us feel better that we did so well and we have chosen something this person actually likes and uses. We hope that this gift will remind this person of our attitude to this person. We hope that every time this gift will give a certain emotion. So when, for example, a man is bringing flowers to the lady on their first date, he hopes to earn some extra points in the eyes of this lady. So these flowers, you can't tell that it's the gift only for her. It is the emotion that will help them make their date more romantic. It can be an impulse that will make this acquaintance more romantic. And when the lady will return back home after the date, she will look at these flowers that will stand in her bedroom or in her kitchen, and she will think about this date and she will think about this man. So of course, when he calls her again and asks her out on a second date, the chances that she will say yes are stronger. So when a gentleman is buying flowers for the first date, he wants to get extra points. He wants to make sure that if he likes this lady and wants to proceed with her, his chances to get a second date are way stronger. Of course, flowers can't buy you a second date, but they can increase your chances. And if you are really into a lady, if you really try to do your best courting her, then all points count. So people who claim that Ukrainian women are materialistic and they just want things from guys, you should think about your attitude to the whole situation. First of all, don't forget that cultures are different. And while for the lady in the US, flowers are not the must on the first date, and I have been following a few colleagues of mine, dating coaches in the West, who work with American women. And one dating coach, she has recommended ladies, if, for example, she is not that into the guy on the first date and she is not sure to go out with him on a second date or not, and she's still doubting to give it a chance or not, she recommends her American female clients to suggest to split the bill. Like, if you are not sure you like the guy, split the bill, and then you can decide if you want to go on a second date or not. In Ukraine, Ukrainian men, they love being masculine, and they are proud to be men. So when a Ukrainian woman suggests to split the bill, she will offend the man. She will try to put his masculinity down, and women don't do that. So even if the lady doesn't like a man that much and she already understands that probably there won't be a second date, she doesn't want to crush his ego completely by suggesting to split the bill. Well, the society in the US is different, and women are not thinking that they will crush the male ego if she suggests to split the bill because she doesn't like him enough to go out with him on a second date. The process of courtship is important in Ukraine. I did a video about it, and I will leave the link below this video so you can listen to it if you haven't listened already. But you have to understand that this process is important not only to the lady but also to the man, because this process builds a special anticipation. It builds a certain level of romance that the couple will take with them into relationship, into their family life if they start one. So it is important to really go through this process of courtship and do it thoroughly. And if you will try to think about building a relationship as to the sale process, like, I have paid for dinner, so now you have to do something for me, now you have to pay for something else, guys, it will lead you to nowhere, especially in Eastern Europe. Men want to date beautiful women, and many men feel offended that, for example, a lady has showed up on a date wearing her yoga pants and a sweater, while he is wearing a jacket and a nice white shirt, and he has actually invested effort, has actually invested time into looking good, and now he feels disappointed that the lady obviously didn't invest any time and didn't do any effort to look good for him. So when a lady arrives on the date and she's beautiful, she's wearing a new dress, her hair is done, her makeup is done, then that's her effort to make this date go in the right direction. Because in Ukraine, women know that men love with their eyes. And of course, she expects to be treated with respect. She expects to be courted, because that's part of our culture. And as they say, when in Rome, do as Romans do. So you can't expect to bring your Western traditions, and you can't expect to actually choose what suits you best from this Western tradition and try to implement them into your dating process in Ukraine. And of course, keep in mind that when I'm speaking about courting, when I'm speaking about flirt relationship, I rely on experience of work with real people, real clientele, male and female. And these people, they are not at paper letter dating sites. You can't meet them in the cheap club dancing on the table. These are ladies who respect themselves. In my base, I think 95% of ladies have a master's or bachelor's university degree. I don't have the statistic how many people have PhD, but I almost every week interview at least two or three people who have a PhD or MBA. So as you can imagine, these are not male or the brides, and you can't order such a woman by mail. I understand why some men hesitate and feel stingy to buy flowers for a date with a male or the bride, because his logic is, well, I'm ordering her from catalog, why to bother with flowers? Guys, it's like a trashy catalog. If you see their half-naked ladies, and they all claim, all ladies through that website claim that they are open to date someone from 25 and up till 65, and she's, for example, 24, I can tell without looking at that profile that this is fake. How is it humanly possible to create a website where you have so many female profiles and they all are open to the age gap of 15, 20, 25 years? Like, is it the website for desperate people? Like, it's unrealistic. And deep down, those males who are using such website, they understand that this is not real, that this is fake. And of course, it is complicated to treat the bride that you can order by mail like a lady. So this is why such gentlemen do not feel like courting that woman, because deep down they understand that it's just a delusion. Real Ukrainian women, they are prideful, and for them, marrying a guy to have a passport, for a very few ladies it would be a solution, for a very few. So thinking that just because you are from Australia, from Canada, or from the US, you will be popular in Ukraine, you will face a huge disappointment. Not so long ago, I have watched a video on YouTube, and a gentleman, I don't know, maybe he's from the US, he has been to Ukraine a few times, and he was talking that it is better to take a lady out on the coffee date because it is way cheaper, and it is better to schedule like 3, 4, 5 coffee dates, and maybe to invite like 20 ladies for these coffee dates within a few dates, and then you will have more options. And I wanted to do this biggest facepalm because it is the most ridiculous dating advice I have ever heard. Why? Because a coffee date for a first date is a nightmare idea for almost every lady. A coffee date can work if you know each other, kind of know each other. For example, you are working in the same office building, and from time to time you meet by the elevator or in the parking lot, and you have talked a few times, and you're not sure whether it can go somewhere, so he's asking you to have some coffee in the same office building during your lunch break. Or maybe he's asking you to do it after work. It can work because you kind of know each other and you can give it a try. And if you see during this coffee date that chemistry is there, attraction is there, then you can proceed with the normal date. And if during this date mutual chemistry is there, mutual interest is getting stronger, then the gentleman for sure will ask the lady out to a normal date. Dinner date, a movie date, this is how people do it in Ukraine. But if we are talking about international dating, I doubt it that you had a chance to meet her multiple times by the elevator or in the parking lot. Probably you have either met her on Facebook, online, through the matchmaking service, or through friends. So your first date is your first chance to give a good first impression. And the lady will be anticipating this chance to give a good first impression if she's really interested. So she is buying a new dress, new shoes, she's doing her hair. Pretty often ladies take the whole day off from work to go to the beauty salon and to make sure they look their best. And now imagine a scenario. She is wearing a beautiful dress, her hair is done, her makeup is done, and the guy is taking her to the coffee shop to have coffee. She's there all dressed up in the line waiting for coffee, and people in their sweatpants are looking at her like, probably she went to the party and now she's having coffee. What is she doing here? It's ridiculous. Anticipation and romantic atmosphere are a must for a first date. It doesn't mean, though, that you have to take her to the most expensive restaurant. Though some ladies will expect there if it is a usual place where, for example, she goes with her other suitors or where her father is asking her mother to, then she will expect to be asked to a place of the similar level, but still it has to be somewhere nice because first date is a special event. It has to be a special event because what will you tell your grandkids that, oh, for our first date, your grandfather was stingy and he has taken me to the coffee shop. I doubt it. It's not about the money. It's about your attitude. It's about your understanding of family, relationship, gender roles, and romance. We all are craving romance, especially people who are really open to international dating. They are more romantic than people who choose local dating. I know it because we are doing local matchmaking as well, and we are working with local clients, and that's a different type of clientele, both male and female. So 10 coffee dates in 2 days is a very bad idea. You rob yourself from a chance to actually get to know a lady in front of you, to open up and to see if this acquaintance can lead to something quality dating is more important than quantity, and it is very important to set a special atmosphere to earn all those points that you can possibly earn and to make you smile. Guys, I hope it was useful to you, and I hope that you have wonderful mood, that you're looking forward to Christmas, you know already with whom you will celebrate all the Christmas holidays, and I wish you love. Svetlana Mukha from Duolingo.com.